As they fought to end the 100-year war, Zuko and Katara's journey took them full circle, from sworn enemies to lifelong allies. Now let's take a closer look at all their battles along the way. This is the complete timeline of Zuko and Katara's fights. Katara first met Zuko when he invaded the Southern Water Tribe in search of the long-lost Avatar.
He'd be about this age, master of all elements?
Katara's brother Sokka did his best to intervene, but Zuko easily outmatched him. Fortunately, Aang arrived just in time and selflessly offered himself as a prisoner to keep Katara and the rest of the villagers safe.
No, Aang, don't do this!
Don't worry, Katara. It'll be okay.
Fighting one-on-one with the Avatar, Zuko might have bit off more than he could chew. And as Aang escaped, Katara and her brother were right there to rescue their new friend. When Zuko found Katara's necklace on the battlefield, he decided to kidnap her and use it as a bribe to convince her to betray Aang.
My mother's necklace! How did you get that?
I didn't steal it, if that's what you're wondering. Tell me where he is.
Zuko's contracted pirate crew eventually turned on him, and while they were distracted, Aang's flying lemur Momo dropped in to help free Katara. Together, she and Aang unanchored the pirate ship with a little waterbending and set sail. Despite free-falling off a massive waterfall, Team Avatar's favorite flying bison saved the day yet again. While still in possession of Katara's necklace, Zuko employed a bounty hunter named June and her Shirshu, a rare animal with a hypersensitive nose. Using the necklace, June tracked Katara and Sokka over countless miles and took them hostage to lure Aang into a trap. Knowing he was outnumbered, Aang nevertheless charged into the fight headfirst. Once Katara was free, she waterbent a giant blast of perfume towards June's Shirshu, confusing its senses and quickly winning the battle for Team Avatar.
June! No!
As they flew off into the sunset, Aang returned Katara's necklace once and for all.
Aang, how'd you get that?
Zuko asked me to be sure I got it to you.
Oh, that's so sweet of Zuko. Would you give him a kiss for me when you see him?
Sure. Mwah.
Team Avatar eventually made it to the Northern Water Tribe in order for Aang and Katara to further their training with the waterbending master Paku. It wasn't long, however, before soot began to fall from the sky, and the Fire Nation invaded with an entire fleet of ships. While Aang meditated in the spirit world to seek guidance, a rogue Zuko snuck his way into the spirit's oasis and ambushed Katara. Rejuvenated by the rising sun, Zuko was able to free himself from Katara's ice with his Breath of Fire technique. Enraged, Zuko knocked out Katara with a single blow and made his escape with a still unconscious Aang.
You rise with the moon. I rise with the sun.
Failing to plan ahead, Zuko was totally exhausted and lost in a blizzard when Katara caught up with him, and she quickly got her revenge.
Whoa! Here for a rematch?
Trust me, Zuko. It's not gonna be much of a match.
Refusing to let Zuko freeze to death, Team Avatar took him back to the Northern Water Tribe before he slipped away in the chaos of battle. After Aang merged with the Ocean Spirit, Katara and the two armies watched as the Avatar single-handedly ended the invasion. Sometime later, as Zuko traveled alone through the Earth Kingdom, he intervened in a fight between Aang and his sister Azula.
Do you really want to fight me?
Yes, I really do.
Team Avatar Zuko and Iroh then surrounded the crazed Azula.
Well, look at this. Enemies and traitors, all working together.
Sinister as always, the Fire Princess feigns surrender before nearly killing her uncle in her escape. As Zuko cried over his wounded uncle, Katara saw the prince vulnerable for the first time.
Get away from us!
Zuko, I can help!
Zuko and Katara met again after Azula and her friends made their coup on the Earth Kingdom.
Zuko!
While trapped in the crystal catacombs deep underground, the two argued, but made a connection upon learning they had both grown up without their mothers.
The Fire Nation took my mother away from me.
I'm sorry. That's something we have in common.
Katara even offered to heal Zuko's scar with her water from the Spirit's Oasis.
It has special properties, so I've been saving it for something important. I don't know if it would work, but...
While Zuko was conflicted, once Azula arrived, he joined her side, and Katara took the betrayal personally as she and Aang fought for their lives.
I thought you had changed!
I have changed.
As all hope seemed lost, Aang made a last-ditch effort to go into the Avatar state, but was struck down by a bolt of Azula's lightning. Fortunately, Iroh made the choice Zuko couldn't and jumped into the fight, giving Katara a chance to save herself and Aang. Azula's attack would have been fatal if not for the spirit water Katara had nearly given to Zuko. Aang barely survived, and while Zuko was torn by what he had done, the divide between him and Katara had grown further than ever before. After much soul-searching and challenging his father on the Day of Black Sun, Zuko finally defected from the Fire Nation. Upon attempting to join Team Avatar, however, Zuko was immediately sent away.
Get out of here and don't come back! And if we ever see you again, well, we'd better not see you again!
It wasn't so easy for Zuko to sway them, especially once he accidentally burned Toph's feet, and the assassin he had previously hired showed up to finish the job. Thankfully, Sokka's boomerang skills had vastly improved, and he scored a direct bullseye. Combustion Man was defeated, and Zuko miraculously survived. Hesitantly, Team Avatar allowed Zuko to stay as Aang's impromptu firebending teacher, but Katara remained untrustful.
So let me tell you something right now. You make one step backward, one slip up, give me one reason to think you might hurt Aang, and you won't have to worry about your destiny anymore. Because I'll make sure your destiny ends right then and there, permanently.
When Sokka told Zuko about the Fire Nation soldiers who killed his mother, the Fire Prince realized he knew who was responsible. A few hours later, Zuko told Katara, and they set out to track down the leader of the Southern Raiders. Despite their heated past, Katara and Zuko worked well together, and soon came face to face with Yon-Ra, the man who killed Katara's mother. Katara almost ended Yon-Ra's life, but ultimately decided revenge was not going to bring her satisfaction, and she and Zuko walked away. Upon returning to camp, Katara finally forgave Zuko. After reuniting with the Order of the White Lotus, Iroh told his nephew to take back his throne to bring peace to the Fire Nation once and for all.
But Azula will be there, waiting for you.
I can handle Azula.
Not alone. You'll need help.
You're right. Katara, how would you like to help me put Azula in her place?
It would be my pleasure.
United in a single cause, Katara and Zuko had Iroh's faith that they would defeat Azula.
Goodbye, everyone. Today, destiny is our friend. I know it.
When they arrived at the Fire Nation Palace, Zuko told Katara to stand back, choosing to face Azula one-on-one in an Agni Kai.
What are you doing? She's playing you. She knows she can't take us both, so she's trying to separate us.
I know, but I can take her this time.
But even you admitted to your uncle that you would need help facing Azula.
There's something off about her. I can't explain it, but she's slipping. And this way, no one else has to get hurt.
With their firebending enhanced by Sozin's comet, Zuko and Azula launched walls of fire at one another. Just as Zuko was gaining the upper hand, Azula summoned up a bolt of lightning and broke the rules of the fight, sending it straight towards Katara. Sacrificing himself, Zuko saved Katara's life, but he also left her to fend for herself against a crazed Azula. After one of the hardest fights of her life, Katara bested Azula by playing her own game of trickery against her. As Azula was trapped, frozen in ice, Katara healed Zuko just in time and embraced her now lifelong friend.
Thank you, Katara.
I think I'm the one who should be thanking you.
With Ozai defeated, Katara watched proudly as Zuko was crowned Fire Lord and vowed to lead his nation into a peaceful future. That night, as Team Avatar celebrated, Zuko took his vow even further and asked Aang to make him a promise. If he should ever start down his father's dark path, Zuko asked his friends to end his life. Katara made the deciding vote, hoping her friend had changed once and for all. After a year as Fire Lord and several assassination attempts in his palace walls, Zuko seemed to be falling into old habits. He became paranoid and secluded himself far away in the Fire Nation colony of Yudao. While there, Zuko learned his citizens were being removed from their homes as part of a peace treaty with the Earth Kingdom. When Team Avatar showed up to talk things out, the Fire Nation soldiers attacked, and so did Zuko. Aang nearly went into the Avatar state to fulfill Zuko's promise, but trusting her instincts, Katara broke up the fight. Everyone calmed down and decided to meet later with the Earth King to work out an agreement. Rather than peace, the infuriated Earth King decided to send his entire army to Yudao. Racing to the battlefield, Aang confronted Zuko, but Katara stopped him before he ended it right then and there. After Aang meditated in the spirit world, he realized the four nations shouldn't be divided by borders any longer, and that Zuko had been right all along. When the dust settled, Aang would end up saving his friend's life, and the Earth King was convinced to allow the Fire Nation colonists to stay. Soon after making peace in Yudao, Katara and most of Team Avatar joined Zuko in the search for his mother, Ursa. To the gang's surprise, they were forced to include Azula in the journey as she had the only clue to her mother's location. Her usual self, Azula was chaotic every step of the way, causing fights, but also saving them from an angry spirit at one point. After a tip from nearby villagers, Team Avatar found their way to a forest filled with spiritual energy known as the Forgetful Valley. Soon, they found themselves face to face with a giant wish-granting spirit called the Mother of Faces. Before Aang could even ask anything, Azula rushed forward and took the wish, demanding to know what happened to Ursa. The Mother of Faces revealed she had helped Zuko and Azula's mother start a new life by giving her a different face and wiping away her memories. Ursa was in fact one of the villagers they met earlier, and Azula took off to confront her with Zuko hot on her tail. The Mother of Faces was also infuriated and commanded her spirits to attack Katara and Aang. Meanwhile, Zuko managed to stop his sister from hurting their mother, and although Azula escaped, Ursa now knew her true identity. Soon after the Mother of Faces was calmed down, Ursa returned and was granted back her old face and memories. While it was tearful, Katara and the rest of Team Avatar got to watch Zuko get a long overdue family reunion. Zuko wouldn't see Katara and Team Avatar again until a revolt in the Southern Water Tribe gathered leaders from around the four nations to discuss a solution. The revolutionaries, led by a Water Tribe warrior named Gilok, used the opportunity to attack and captured the Earth King in the process. Refusing to surrender, the Radicals made their last stand over a perilous chasm called the Bridge of No Return. As Gilok set the rope bridge on fire, he tried to take as many people with him as possible. Unfortunately, Zuko and Katara were there to make some daring rescues. Team Avatar gained a few new members that night, and Zuko and Katara feasted as friends for many more years to come. The future reign of Fire Lord Zuko was long and peaceful, and Katara ended up starting a family with Aang and settling down to help in the formation of Republic City. As far as their fights on and off the battlefield, that's all we know so far. From hot-headed young benders to masters in each of their elements, Zuko and Katara met as adversaries and grew into old friends, each with their share of wins, losses, and everything in between. But what do you think? Who came out on top? Comment below and keep watching for more of your favorite Avatar moments.